Hello, it's me, Hendo. What I have here today in my table. This is called Pentultimate. This puzzle is a deep cut face-turning puzzle. As you can see, the pieces will rotate around this face, but we can rotate all these centers and all these parts of the corners. So it's like it was a cube, but in a dodecahedron modification in terms of pieces. But examining this puzzle, I have also another modification of this puzzle here in terms of shape. That is this puzzle here. This is called Icosamate. These two puzzles are the same because with this puzzle here, when I rotate this face in this way, with these two corners that are in here, when I rotate this face in this way, these two corners are near, because now the corners of this puzzle are, so the corner for this puzzle are these pieces. So we have five corners around one center. Here we have five corners, so these triangles around one center. But the problem of this puzzle here is that each of this center now has a specific orientation. While with this puzzle here, the pieces are flat of the centers, and we have the specific orientation of the corners. But with this puzzle here, we could have a really strange parity with only one center that is rotated with all these five kind of rotation. So it could be rotated with 1, 2, 3, or 4, because the last is the true position of the piece. And to solve that parity, you have only to consider none of all the parity around the face of this corner that was rotated unsolved. So for example, if it was unsolved in this position here with the orange here rather than here, you have to rotate the face directly, then you have to solve again all the centers. But today now it's time to continue the examination of this puzzle here, and I have also another high order version of this puzzle, that is this puzzle here. This is the Master Pentultimate. Because master, because here we have, rather than here that we have only two layers, here we have 1, 2, and 3 layers. So you can imagine now the difficulty of this puzzle here, because now the pieces are really a lot. Okay, but continuing the examination of this puzzle, I have a combination, a really huge collection made by a hybrid puzzle that combines the movement of a Pentultimate with other kind of puzzles. For example, the first one was this puzzle here. I don't know if you remember, but this puzzle is called Curvy Helimate. I've made it using the 3D printed parts made by High Materialized, and it turns great. And these pieces can also rotate with a Pentultimate rotation in this side, in all the directions. You can see the puzzle turns great in each direction. So this is the Curvy Helimate that combines the movement of a Pentultimate that you have seen with the rotation of these edges. Okay, so this is an edge turning plus Pentultimate. Then I have another kind of puzzle that is this one here, that is called Rexmate. The Rexmate now combines the movement of a Pentultimate with these kind of turning, with the movements of this kind of rotation. That which kind of rotation is this? Examining this puzzle, you can see that the faces of this puzzle are equal to the faces of the Bauhinia, the Rex dodecahedron. The Rex dodecahedron is a shape modification of a face-turning icosahedron in a dodecahedron shape modification that is called Radiolarian 2. And that puzzle has all these pieces that you can see, but here with this pad we have also up and ultimate rotation that can add new pieces of the resolutions, because this edge is split in 4 pieces and these petals are split in 1/2. Okay, then I have another puzzle that looks like this. That is this one here. This is a monster. This is the Spartacus. I'm the first in the world to have solved a Spartacus. I have invented an algorithm to move all these parts of the edges around, and then I have solved it without any problem, because this puzzle now adds to this puzzle here these parts, this central piece, because these are the centers of my faces. And with these centers, you could have another kind of parity. Okay, now I wanna continue, not with the penultimate, but with this puzzle here. This is the icosamate, no? I have another kind of a puzzle that looks like this with the 3 layers, because now with this puzzle we have 2 layers, no? I have a puzzle that has apparently 3 layers. That is this puzzle here. This is called Icosaminx, and you can see the 3 layers, but you can't move the 3 layers with this puzzle, because this puzzle is only a face turning icosahedron, so each face, each of the, their 20 faces can rotate. Okay, so this is different from a Master Penultimate version of this puzzle here. But today I have another box to open with you. So here we go. Okay, so this is my package. It comes from Korea, from my dear friend Andrew Gilly, the same designer that has made for me the Rexmate, if you remember. Okay, so here we go. Okay, wait to see the quality of this puzzle here. That is a really extreme puzzle. That has confused me a lot, because I have paired it to another kind of puzzle. But then I have received a really strange news. So, wow, it's so small. Okay, I believe that I don't have anything else. Okay, I don't have nothing else. I'm gonna continue. Wow. Oh my god. I can't believe to my eyes. Because this puzzle is really, really tiny. It's really impressive. Wow. Which puzzle is this? This tiny puzzle is called the Elite Icosamate. Wow. So now with this puzzle we can rotate all these deep faces, as you can see with this puzzle here. We have the same kind of the deep faces rotation. So with this center and all these 5 centers around it, that now it has more pieces. So we can rotate now 1, 2, 3, and 4 layers. This is Elite Icosamate. I'm so impressed, because it turns great. Wow. I love all the puzzles that Andrew Gilly makes for me, because they turn extremely well. I can't wait to solve this puzzle. But examining now this puzzle, okay, I wanna put back all the puzzles in my desk. And then understanding which kind of puzzle is this. I have thought that it looks like a Elite Penultimate version in a icosahedron shape modification. This was my first theory that I have applied with this puzzle. But then I have paired a picture of a regular Elite Penultimate to a picture of a Elite Ecosamate. As with these pictures here. And then I have identified that the Elite Pentultimate has more pieces than this puzzle here. So in my opinion, this puzzle wasn't an Elite Pentultimate in a shape modification, with a icosahedron shape modification. So I have talked with Andrew about this puzzle, and he told me that this puzzle here was a shape modification of a Pentultimate, because now we have, as you can see, the same kind of pieces that we can have with the Pentultimate in a shape modification. Let's turn back. Okay, so it's a combination with a Pentultimate and which other kind of puzzle. So now we have now another puzzle that can add this family of these three hybrid puzzles, because now this puzzle is the combination of a Pentultimate and this puzzle here, the Starminx. Oh my god. So combining these two puzzles, you could have this puzzle in a icosahedron shape modification. That means that it's a super cube version of these two puzzles fused together. That you can imagine a Pentultimate line in this pentagon, like in this face here. So you can imagine also the picture that was this one here that he told me. And the difficulty that I could have when I try to solve a puzzle like this. I can't wait to do that, because I believe that I can solve a puzzle like this. I have only to study how to move the pieces around, and then I probably could make a tutorial about it. So only for now, I want to congratulate again my dear friend Andrew to have given me a puzzle that is a monster that turns like a dream, and nothing. Only for now, thanks for watching, guys.